Hi dear kids, this is Srinivasan from Idle Metal Research School. Today the topic we are going to discuss is Rebellion of Veerapandiya Kattabomman. He is one of the most famous freedom fighter in Tamil Nadu history. Before going to the class, I am going to ask 5 questions from previous chapter. Just answer it through your comments. Question number 1. Who introduced polygar system in Tamil Nadu? Question number 2. Who was recalled and dismissed from service by the British East India Company? Question number 3. What is the another name of Yusuf Khan? Question number 4. Velunachiyar lived under the protection of Das at Virupachi. Question number 5. Pulithevar tried to get the support of Das from Mysore. Rebellion of Veerapandiya Kattabomman 1790 to 1799. Veerapandiya Kattabomman became the Palayakarar of Panchalam Kuruchi at the age of 30 on the death of his father Jagaveerapandiya Kattabomman. So his father name is Jagaveerapandiya Kattabomman. The company's administrators James London and Colin Jackson had considered him a man of peaceful disposition. However, soon several events led to conflict between Veerapandiya Kattabomman and the East India Company. So Veerapandiya Kattabomman considered as the enemy of British East India Company. The Nawab, under the provisions of a treaty signed in 1781, had assigned the revenue of the Carnatic to the company to be entirely under their management and control during the war with Mysore Sultan. 1/6 of the revenue was to be allowed to meet the expenses of Nawab and his family. These sessions previously, the last class, we have discussed. The company had thus gained the right to collect taxes from Panchalam Kuruchi. The company appointed its collector to collect taxes from all the palayams. The collectors humiliated the palayakarars and adopted force to collect the taxes. This was the bone of contention between the English and Kattabomman. So the Kattabomman didn't like the way of approach of British East India Company when they collected taxes, because the British peoples, they are followed that crucial method to follow to collect the taxes from the Palayakarars. Confrontation with Jackson. The land revenue arrears from Kattabomman was 3,310 pakodas in 1798. Pakoda means rupees. During the period of 18th century, they are called as a pakoda. Collector Jackson, an arrogant English officer, wanted to send an army to collect the revenue dues, but the Madras government did not give him permission. On 18th August 1798, he ordered Kattabomman to meet him in Ramanathapuram, but Kattabomman's attempts to meet him in between proved futile, yet Jackson refused to give him both in Kutralam and Srivilliputtur. At last, an interview was granted and Kattabomman met Jackson in Ramanathapuram on 19th September 1798. It is said that Kattabomman had to stand for 3 hours before the haughty collector Jackson. Seizing danger, Kattabomman tried to escape along with his minister Siva Subramanianar. So the Kattabomman minister is Siva Subramanianar. Umathurai suddenly entered the fort with his men and helped the escape of கட்ட பொம்மன். At the gate of the Ramanathapuram fort, there was a class in which some people, including Lieutenant Clark, were killed. Siva Subramanianar was taken prisoner. Appearance before Madras Council. On his return to Panjalam Kuruchi, Kattabomman represented to the council about how he was ill-treated by the collector Jackson. The council asked Kattabomman to appear before a committee with William Brown, William Oram and John Casamajor as members. Meanwhile, Governor Edward Clive ordered the release of Subramanianar and the suspension of the collector Jackson. Kattabomman appeared before the committee that sat on 1798 and reported on what transpired in Ramanathapuram. The committee found Kattabomman was not guilty. Jackson was dismissed from service and a new collector S.R. Lusington appointed. Kattabomman cleared almost all the revenue arrears, only a balance of 1080 pakodas. Kattabomman and the Confederacy of Palayakarars. In the meantime, Marudu Bondir of Sivagangai formed the South Indian Confederacy of rebels against the British. With the neighboring Palayakarars like Kobala Nayak of Dindukal and Yadul Nayak of Anamalai, Marudu Bondir acted as its leader. The Tiruchirappalli proclamation had been made. Kattabomman was interested in this confederacy. Collector Lusington prevented Kattabomman from meeting the Marudu brothers. But Marudu brothers and Kattabomman jointly decided on the confederation with the English. Kattabomman tried to influence Sivagiri Palayakarars who refused to join. Kattabomman advanced towards Sivagiri, but the Palayakarars of Sivagiri was a tributary to the company. So the company considered the expedition of Kattabomman as a challenge to their authority. The company ordered the army to march on to Tirunelveli, the siege of Panjalam Kuruchi. In May 1799, Lord Wellesley issued order from Madras for the advance of forces from Tiruchirappalli, Tanjavur and Madurai to Tirunelveli. Major Bannerman commanded the troops. The Travancore troops too joined the British. On 1st September 1799, an ultimatum was served on Kattabomman to surrender. Kattabomman's evasive reply prompted Bannerman to attack his fort. Bannerman moved his entire army to Panchi on 5th September. They cut off all the communications to the fort. Bannerman deputed Ramalinganar to convey a message asking Kattabomman to surrender. Kattabomman refused. He told all the secret of the fort, and on the basis of his report, Bannerman decided the strategy of a operation. In a class at Kallarpatti, Sivasubramanianar was taken a prisoner. Execution of Kattabomman. Kattabomman escaped to Pudukottai. The British put a price on his head. Betrayed by the Rajas of Ettayapuram and Pudukottai, Kattabomman was finally captured. Sivasubramanianar was executed at Nagalapuram on the 13th September. Bannerman made a mockery of a trial for Kattabomman in front of the Palayakarars on 16th October. During the trial, Kattabomman bravely admitted all the charges leveled against him. Kattabomman was hanged from a tamarind tree in the old fort of Kayathar, close to Tirunelveli, in front of the fellow Palayakarars. Thus ended the life of celebrated Palayakarars of Panjalam Kuruchi. Many folk ballads on Kattabomman helped keep his memory alive among the people. Next, these two people also one of the important freedom fighter in our Tamil Nadu, the Marudu brothers, Periya Marudu or Vella Marudu, and his younger brother Chinna Marudu were able generals of Muthu Vadugar of Sivagangai. After Muthu Vadugar's death in the Kalayar Kovil battle, Marudu brothers assisted in restoring the throne to Velanachiyar. In the last years of the 18th century, Marudu brothers organized resistance against the British. After the death of Kattabomman, they worked along with his brother Umathurai. They plundered the granaries of the Nawab and caused damage and destructions to company troops. Rebellion of Marudu brothers 1800 to 1801. Despite the suppression of Kattabomman's revolt in 1799, rebellion broke out again in 1800. In the British records, it is referred to as the Second Palayakarar War. It was directly by a confederacy consisting of Marudu Pandian of Sivagangai, Gopala Nayak of Dindukal, Kerala Verma of Malabar, and Krishnappa Nayak and Dudanji of Mysore. In April 1800, they meet at Virupachi and decided to organize an uprising against the company. The uprising, which broke out in Coimbatore in June 1800, soon spread to Ramanathapuram and Madurai. The company got wind of it and declared war on Krishnappa Nayak of Mysore, Kerala Verma of Malabar and others. The Palayakarars of Coimbatore, Satyamangalam and Tharapuram were caught and hanged. In February 1801, the two brothers of Kattabomman, Umathurai and Sevathaiya, escaped from the Palayamkottai prison to Kamudi, from where Chinna Marudu took them to Siruvayal, his capital. The fort at Panjalanguruchi was reconstructed in record time. The British troops under Colin Macaulay retook the fort in April, and the Marudu brothers sought shelter in Sivagangai. The English demanded that the Marudu Pandiyars hand over the fugitive Umathurai and Sevathaiya, but they refused. Colonel Agnew and Colonel Innes marched on Sivagangai. In June 1801, Marudu Pandiyars issued a proclamation of independence, which is called Tiruchirappalli Proclamation. Proclamation of 1801. The proclamation of 1801 was an early call to the Indians to unite against the British, cutting across region, caste, creed and religion. The proclamation was posted on the walls of the Nawab's palace in Tiruchirappalli fort and on the walls of the Srirangam temple. Many Palayakarars of Tamil country rallied together to fight against the English. Chinna Marudu collected nearly 20,000 men to challenge the English army. British reinforcements were rushed from Bengal, Ceylon and Malaya. The Rajas of Pudukottai, Ettayapuram and Tanjavur stood by the British divine and rule policy, followed by the English, split the forces of the Palayakarars soon for Sivagangai. In May 1801, the English attacked the rebels in Tanjavur and Tiruchirappalli. The rebels went to Piranmalai and Kalayar Kovil. They were again defeated by the forces of the English. In the end, the superior military strength and the able commander of the English company prevailed. The rebellion failed and Sivagangai was annexed in 1801. The Marudu brothers were executed in the fort of Tiruppattur near Ramanathapuram on 24th October 1801. Umathurai and Sevathaiya were captured and beheaded at Panjalanguruchi on 16th November 1801. 73 rebels were exiled to Penang in Malaya. Though the Palayakarars fell to the English, their exploits and sacrifices inspired later generations. Thus, the rebellion of Marudu brothers, which is called South Indian Rebellion, is a landmark event in the history of Tamil Nadu. Carnatic Treaty 1801. the suppression of the Palayakkara's rebellion of 1799 and 1800 to 1801 resulted in the liquidations of all the local chieftains of Tamil Nadu. Under the terms of the Carnatic Treaty of 31st July 1801, the British assumed direct control over Tamilagam, and the Palayakkara systems came to an end with the demolition of all forts and disbandment of their army. Okay guys, our lesson came to an end. In this chapter, we have discussed how Veerapandiya Kattabomman, Marudu Pandiyar rose their voice against the East India Company, what are the things they are followed to against the British government. So these all the things we have deeply discussed from this chapter. British followed divide and rule policy. It really helped them to create the partition between all the Palayakkarars in our South India. So these things only created partition between that all the Palayakkarars, and it will help them to create the diversity between the Palayakkarars. So finally, British East India Company easily killed all the freedom fighters, those who all raised their voice against the East India Company. That's all guys, once recall it from the beginning. See you on next video. Bye bye from Srinivasan. Love you all and stay happy. Bye bye.